Hey everyone, welcome back to the B-Movie Bunker. Today we are looking at 1989's Cannibal Women of the Avocado Jungle, brought to us by J.F. Lawton. Lawton did some work with Full Moon Pictures a while back, and then went on to get a little more fame writing things such as Pretty Woman. There are some out there who consider this one a cult classic. What we have is a story of this feminist, played by Shannon Tweed, who was hired by the U.S. military and the U.S. government to go into the avocado belt, the avocado jungle, in Southern California to look for this other feminist doctor who was sent in there and to ensure the safety of the avocado industry, because the dreaded piranha women who live in the avocado jungle eat any men they find. If you can't tell, this is obviously supposed to be a comedy. It is, it's a satire, for one, of Heart of Darkness, much in the way that, like, Apocalypse Now was a retelling of Heart of Darkness. This one obviously is more of a spoof than Apocalypse Now was. Apocalypse Now was not meant to be a comedy, as far as I can tell from having watched it. This is also a bit of commentary on the whole war of the sexes, and at times it does that okay, but I think a lot of the humor, it's just, I don't know, it's a little too campy, a little too cheesy, and I think it's definitely dated. You have the male lead in this, played by Bill Maher. I'm trying to remember, was there a time when Bill Maher was considered funny? Because he certainly is not a good actor. I guess I can't completely blame him for the lines he's given, but his delivery... There's a reason why a lot of stand-up comedians don't transition to be actors, is because the delivery of a joke in a stand-up act is much different than the delivering of lines in a film. And I think Bill Maher definitely suffers from the fact that he is reading his lines as if he's talking to an audience as opposed to interacting with characters on screen. You also have Adrienne Barbeau, who plays the other feminist doctor who has gone all native with the piranha women. And I don't know. I see people who are just like, you know, drool over Adrienne Barbeau, and I don't get it, because she's always looked... I try to think of the friendliest way to put it, but just rugged. I don't think she's ugly. I'm not saying she's ugly. It's just these people who act like, you know, she was like the best thing from like that late 70s, you know, 80s era as far as women went. I just don't get it. Her acting is okay. She's probably the best actor in this film, what little bit there is, but then it also culminates in probably one of the worst choreographed and just poorly displayed sword fights, fencing, ever. And I understand it's comedy and it's campy and it's cheesy, but it's like they weren't even putting any effort into some of the scenes that they were doing, and especially the sword fight scene. It just seemed so lazy and lackadaisical, just so poorly thrown together. Scale of 1 to 10, this is, you know, we'll stick with the avocado theme. It's like, you know, you made some guacamole, you know, you have some friends over and you're eating, and somehow you manage to leave an avocado pit in the guacamole. And I know they're big, so leaving that in there is pretty impressive to do. And one of your friends, you know, takes a chip and swells an avocado pit. Also pretty impressive. But then your friend is thrashing around, choking, and at first it's funny, you're laughing. You're like, hey, look at him choking on the... And then your friend's dead. And then it becomes sad. And then your party's remembered is that, oh yeah, I remember that party. That's where Bob died because you fucked up the dip. That's how I kind of felt with this movie. It just, I don't know, it wanted to be funny, but it just... Everything seemed to fall flat. Everything seemed to die before it actually could take root and grow into something funny. So, I don't know. There are those who consider this a cult classic. I can't see watching this ever again. There's part of me that thinks that I may have seen parts of it way back when it first came out, but I don't know. It wasn't good. I don't get it. I don't understand how it was supposed to be funny. There was just too much that was... It was poorly acted, poorly delivered, poorly written, but a decent premise. The thing is you go into this watching and you're thinking you're going to get like a Russ Meyers flick, and you don't get that. You get women in little skimpy outfits, but that doesn't make a movie. So that's all I've really got for this one. Until next time, why don't you all stay safe out there in the wasteland, folks.